These are the nine truths about purgatory. Some fear it, others hope for it. Some see it as proof of God's mercy, others as testimony to God's wrath. Many don't know anything about it, while many more have forgotten what they once knew. The it is purgatory, and when it comes to Catholic beliefs about the afterlife, the Church's teachings on purgatory have long been among its most contested and misunderstood. Yet, despite all the confusion, the teachings themselves aren't that complicated. At their most basic, they can be boiled down to nine essential truths. Truths that not only illuminate the Church's doctrine, but also reveal the eternal significance of those teachings for us and those we have lost. So what are those essentials? Purgatory exists. That may seem like stating the obvious, but for some Catholics, purgatory has become what pastor, author, and blogger Father Dwight Longnecker called the forgotten doctrine. Many modern Catholics don't know what purgatory is anymore, said Father Longnecker, who blogs at Standing on My Head. They bought into the idea that sin has no consequences, that everyone goes to heaven because God is too nice to send anyone anywhere else. The Church's doctrine on purgatory, however, proclaims the opposite. It reminds us that sin does have consequences, eternal ones, and that while God is love, He still honors the free choices made by men and women. That's the terrifying compliment God pays the creature, said Dr. Regis Martin, professor of theology at Franciscan University, and author of Still Point, Lost Longing, and Love of God. He takes seriously the freedom we exercise, even if it carries us straight into hell. That being said, he continued, while hopefully few of us are so wicked that we would choose to be wretched forever without God, not many of us are so pure that we can be catapulted straight into the arms of God. Most of us are somewhere in between. Hence the need for purgatory, the final purification of those who die in friendship with God, but who haven't fully broken their attachment to sin or atoned for wrongs done in this life. When we stand before Christ the Judge, all the compromises we have made, all the gray areas into which our choices led us, have to be accounted for, said Martin. We've got to square accounts with the judge. Purgatory isn't merely a punishment. It's a merciful gift and a testimony to God's love. Sometimes people hear about the sufferings of the souls in purgatory, and they think suffering is a desire of a vindictive God, a God who wants his pound of flesh, said Robert Corzine, Vice President for Programs and Development at the St. Paul Center for Biblical Theology. That's not the case at all, he continued. God forgives us immediately when we ask. The role of suffering is to undo the damage we have done. It's God the healer applying the remedy to make us perfect images of Christ. And perfect images of Christ is exactly what God calls each of us to become. According to the Catholic doctrine of salvation, God doesn't simply desire to save us from hell, from a state of eternal separation from Him. More fundamentally, He desires to save us from sin, from being anything less than the man and women He created us to be. God is like a great heart surgeon trying to give us the new hearts we need, Corzine said. But we keep flopping around on the table, moving away from the knife. Death, then, is like the anesthetic. In purgatory, we are no longer able to resist the healing we need, and he can finish the task he began during our lifetime.